Okay, so we'll go for a three-hole blog, Michael.
Three-hole blog.
Because I don't know, it might be.
I don't know. I see other people do it.
I normally do a nine-hole. So,
well, yes, but I'm not making an hour-long video. So anyway, we'll go for a three-hole vlog. There we go, three-hole vlog. Michael and I have just hit a couple of lovely tee shots. It's not really, after the first four hits, two of each driver, much of a competition between the Cobra F9 and my old tight list. So, this is ball number two with the tight list. And this is about in line, so I've just outdriven Michael. All right, we're the same, which was generally it. I was generally here about the same distance with that. And then there's the other one, about 15 yards up, going to there. Okay, so this is Michael with 210 yards, are we calling it 210? 210 yards in. Four hybrid, water on the left, bunker short, have I? And it's a lovely strike. I'm not going to try and zoom in because phones don't zoom. Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
Good man.
Where Ashley's landed up on his second shot, yes, all 15 yards ahead of me, but he plays off a lot lower handicap than I do.
My club.
Which is unbelievable.
Serious.
I'll never forget, we were watching a guy who does trick shots, and he said, oh yeah, clean grooves helps spin and helps keep it accurate. Ash tried it the next day and it got worse.
Mud is the way to go.
Alright, hole is down. You can just see the flag. Sounded a little thin. Where's it gone?
Low under the wind.
It's just rolled about a foot short of the green, or 2 foot short of the green. So we're both a bit short. I don't think either of us allowed for the wind that's actually coming into our face.
Okay. So this is Michael playing off 18. His first shot. 20. Actual handicap of 20, but we play him off 18 because he doesn't want two shots in every hole because it demasculates him.
Are we having two shots every hole tonight?
If you have two shots every hole, we will win. Right then, so I reckon you've got 50 yards. 40 yards then. He's gone a little bit right. It's pin high.
Just off the toe.
And here's me, just short of the green after hitting it very low under the wind. Michael's given up course vlogging duties for the hole. So in addition to playing golf today, Michael and I recently learnt about aim point putting, which is what he's doing.
Trying to.
So we're going to see how it goes, because he didn't trust his feet the first time.
Still don't now. Feet pretty much say it's like flat and straight, but that's a lot higher than that.
Yeah, greens are made to be deceptive. Or maybe Michael just hasn't got very good balance. Not as much as me. Oh, that's a big break.
Okay. So he's got his line.
Well, that doesn't feel right.
We'll find out in a minute. Oh, it's behind the hole. Not bad though. Not bad. So, two fives?
Fives.
Two bogeys.
Two fives to start.
I'm very happy with that.
Good for you.
On the cathedral. We're playing off the whites. Oh, get my head out of the way. 362. Two large bunkers down the middle and one on the left. And looking down, looks always longer on camera than it does anywhere else, but there's the bunker on the left over there, and there's the two running down there. So we'll go to Ash's shot now. Ash's swing plane. He gets very under the swing plane to begin with, but as he comes through, much more along the sort of line it should be.
Dead straight. And that's gone down the left hand side. Safe as houses though. Nice bounce right. A member's bounce, Michael. A member's bounce.
This is Ash's second shot. We've got about 130 to the pin. We haven't actually zapped it, even though I do have a zapper. We're downwind, so he's taking a little off. Like he's struck that nice. He's short front. Didn't quite trust me on my yardage. And I am over there, so we'll just pop over there.
Mikey's zapping the hole to see how close he was with 130.
132.
Oh, now if he said 132, I would have hit a 9-iron.
That is to the pin.
Yeah, I would have hit a 9-iron.
So I am hitting a 9-iron.
Anyway, this is what Mikey's got left.
Probably don't want to hit this one.
I'm going to give him slight credit that he outdrove my 3-wood by a yard. He's, if that's the club, he's close. Oh, he's just over the back. There for one again, I believe. Bandits. So what Mikey doesn't realise is I'm going to announce this as a scratch 3-hole competition because, well, he might win if we have a handicap. Well, he's certainly winning at the moment. But we'll see. Nothing like beating your little brother. I play off 15, isn't it?
12.
I'm playing off 12.
It was an 8.
I'm playing off 12, which is, I think, personally for me, quite harsh, as I've only played 6 times this 12 months. So I personally believe that's a bit harsh, but I'll let him get away with it.
I think you have played well more than 6 times. Come up to the flag.
This is Chichester flags.
Yeah, I like a flag. I like the logo. They do need a bit of a clean though. They are a bit old now, the flags here. And you got Ash who's just lining up. He's got a long putt. I wouldn't dare say how long. Greens here are also a little bit struggling after winter. It's quite a busy golf course. So where are you aiming? The opposite way of which it looks like from up here. Unless he's converted it. it well. Just not bad. Not bad from all the way back there.
Right then. Mikey for birdie. Ah, oh, short. Like his willy. Still you.
Thank you.
Michael's going with, he's done aim point. He's going straight.
Nice big little hole in front of my ball.
For par. Oh!
It was just a tiny bit.
Take it away. Take it away.
Ash's putt. This is for par. It's going in! Yay!
So I sunk my putt. I'm one up in the scratch competition that Michael's unaware of, but Michael's very pleased. He's three over par, which is to his handicap, being off 18. Moving to the fourth, the final hole of our three hole vlog, and I think there is reason for the opposition. I think there's reason for the opposition tomorrow to be concerned.
Oh yeah, definitely. If I play like this tomorrow, then
yeah,
I've got no chance.
Yeah. There's the opposition. I'm going to put a little montage in, take a few more videos of just us smacking the ball loads, and it's going to scare them. Although they won't see it till after the event because I won't edit it till after. But anyway.
Par three here. 167 to the middle. Water all front. Big bunker protecting. Couple mounds on the left. But you also got a stream running left. There's a lot of water on Chichester course. That is the part of the tower over there. And this is our par three. So, quite a daunting par three at that, with the amount of hazards in it. Flag is just frontish right. So, water and bunker all in play. We'll go to Ash's shot. I think he's hooked it from that ah sound.
Michael, with a chance to level up the scratch score, if he can play a good hole. Oh, it's just short right. Short right of the green. Definitely with a shout to level the scores.
Walking up to the hole. Let's have a little look back. That's where the tee box is. And you know, part of the nice thing about this course is because there's so much water, you get a lot of wildlife around it. Like all sorts of birds and things. They've done a bit of work. Oh yes, definitely, actually. Let's get a bit close on this. If that tuft of grass wasn't there, sorry about my shadow, that would be in the heart. So he's got a pretty unpleasant shot standing from behind the ball. Flag over there. At least he's got lots of green to work with. I certainly won't be standing behind him on this shot, because if I do, I will have wet feet. Oh, it's hit the green, it sounded quite good.
Oh, I'm happy with that.
We walk over, oh yeah, not bad. He's got about a 10-foot putt looking from here. Alright, we'll see what he gets.
Alright, Michael's claiming this is a horrible lie.
It is for the sort of shot I've got to play.
He's got to play a little chip, pitch it in the fringe there. No pressure on him. He's still here for zero because he gets a shot on every hole.
Hey, I'm still new to golf.
It's in the genetics. Oh, that's a lovely shot. Oh, it's just cut, just held up a bit short. Bit short. At least this time your chip got closer than mine.
Ash has just finished lining up. He's put two fingers up for the hole this time, so you think there's a quite a bit more curve using the I've forgotten what it's called. What's it called again?
Aim point.
Aim point technique. Yeah, about a 10-foot putt.
10-foot? How big are your feet?
Alright, 12-foot, 13-foot. I'm not that great at judging short distance, but apparently I'm good at judging longer distance. As mine did land pin high. If he had hit that, it'd probably gone in.
Mike and I are going to have to get the hurry up because the four ball ladies match has caught up with us. Last hole on the vlog. Michael for par. What do you think of my second shot from 240 yards on a par 5?
A bleep 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 for hell bleep's sake.
I mean, of the two balls by the pin there, one of them's mine, the closer one.
I would like to point out, after he struck it, he had a go at himself and dropped his club because he was so annoyed that it hit it so poorly.
I'd also like to point out that Michael told me to play sensibly. If I do that tomorrow, then he won't be complaining. So that, for me, is a chance to go birdie, birdie, eagle.
After,
which is, it would be impressive after I had a 14.